Is this too petty?
Okay.
I told my roommate I needed to study for a test and to please keep it down. They invited a few friends over and blared music until 2 o'clock in the morning. Was it too petty of me to vacuum right outside their door at 6 a.m.?
Welcome back to Under Oath. This next segment, I'd like to title, Is This Too Petty?
Ooh.
They should put that on my stone.
I was going to say, this is made for you,
this
sir.
This falls under my thing. Is Jeff being too petty? Batman. Okay. Question is, I was at the beach for 2 hours with my family. No one else was there. Another family with lots of kids running around. I have a feeling this is a little racist. And set up 5 feet away from us. Feels racist even before I get to it. When the beach was completely empty, we politely asked them for space and they said no. Was it petty for me to dump chips around the area they were in and then leave? Like cow chips? Like potato chips?
Potato chips. I know what they were doing. You know why that happens,
ants?
Right? No. Seagulls. There it is. That will come right down.
I think that's genius.
It may be genius.
Why? But why? I mean, you know, like a movie theater. If there's one guy sitting in the row,
I was going
to
say,
and I walk up and sit down right next to this dude.
That's you're a sociopath.
And the best thing
is, psychotic.
If I'm on the phone when I'm doing it.
Perfect.
Oh,
you are a complete.
And then I talk through the previews.
Douche. Yeah.
Yeah. I'm going, hey, no, it's just a previews. I can keep talking. With all the seats, why would he sit right next to me?
But it's an entire family, though. Like, I don't think they're scamming you. I think they're being oblivious. I don't think they...
But why? Why would you go, hey, oh, they must know something. This is the best 10 feet.
Out of all on the beach?
Yes, out of all the beach. This is the best.
Nobody's here. I'm here by myself.
I mean, was this courtside for them?
I guess so, brother.
And then they actually pretended they were offended that these other people were like, hey, dude, why can't you give me space?
I mean, I think it was... It all has to do with approach, though. Like, is it like, hey, excuse me,
You mind if I sit right next to you?
Yeah.
Why?
I don't know why, bro. Maybe you look like a fun guy.
You know what I do?
What,
Post-COVID, just start hacking.
Just start coughing. I'm fighting something.
I'm not sure if it's COVID or an STD. And just start flinging.
Oh, my God.
You know?
With their kids running around.
Hey, that'll get them far away from me. My goal is to get them away from me.
That's true.
So what do you do? Think of this way. Do you
move. I'm an adult. I just get up and I move.
All right.
Okay. The second one here. Is this too petty?
Okay.
I told my roommate I needed to study for a test and to please keep it down. They invited a few friends over and blared music until 2 o'clock in the morning. Was it too petty of me to vacuum right outside their door at 6 a.m.?
Vengeance.
Yes.
That's what we're asking for.
Yes.
We're saying, you did this to me, so I'm going to torture you.
Yes. And they asked
Is that
them,
the relationship you have?
Well, listen, here's the thing. They're making a lot of noise. And I said, please, man, I'm studying. Can you please keep it down? Nope. Didn't care. At that point, if I ask you and you still keep going, yes, vengeance is mine.
See, I like to wait for it.
What do you mean? Why wait?
I don't deliver on the vengeance immediately. I'm in for the long con.
Okay. You like it served cold.
Oh, yes.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah. We're not even on a vacuum.
Gotcha.
Yeah, no.
No, not noise for noise. You got to go up a level, right?
Yeah.
Gotcha.
Like I would have possibly that, your girlfriend called while you were having the party with all your friends.
That's evil.
Listen, we're roommates.
That's
and I said to you, I told you this. I said, listen, I've got something really important. Please don't screw me.
Yeah.
Now, here's the thing with roommates. Mm-hmm. Sometimes they're just roommate. They're not your mate.
They're not your friend.
Yeah. They just happen to be sharing space.
You're right about that.
Now, it sounds like they're not friends.
No, they're not friends.
Okay. So you have an irritating roommate. You're stuck. You know, basically, he's just there to write the check.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Well, you have a problem. I used to have this roommate who used to like the Arsenio Hall show.
Oh, like whoop, 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 whoop.
And he was white Jamaican, and he had this laugh. And could you imagine?
That's like Mrs. Doubtfire?
Yes.
Okay.
Could you imagine being in your room, you know, trying to take care of business while that laugh? And I'm like, Jason, he's so funny, Jeff. He's so funny.
Gotcha.
I was like, first off, Arsenio Hall, he's funny, but he's not. He wasn't coming to America funny.
You bite your tongue.
Yes. Oh, come on. There's a difference between the Arsenio Hall show
yes.
and coming to America.
It was, well, you're
coming to America was the best.
Oranges, though.
Yes. Yeah, okay. That's when he was really funny. Uh-huh. And the other one was when he was just like, woo, woo, woo.
No, he was hilarious.
Really?
Groundbreaking.
Groundbreaking.
Amazing.
Yes.
Okay.
Is this too petty? My mother-in-law always judges me and the way I parent kids. Is it petty of me to ply my kids with sugar before they go over her house? Ply?
People, you don't ply?
Ply?
I'm always plying.
You plying?
I ply all the
time. You ply?
Bro.
How you ply?
Plying, bro.
Ply this.
Mm-hmm. Ply that.
Ply this. I got your ply right here.
Yeah, I got your ply right here.
I got
here.
Your ply.
There you go.
What he's trying to do is rile the kids up.
Yeah.
Before he delivers them.
Mm-hmm.
This friend of mine gave my kid this really annoying toy. So I gave the kid a drum set.
Ooh.
Yeah. Yeah. I doubled down.
Okay. But here's the thing I'm thinking, though. This could backfire. Because if you drop them off and they're doing you a favor babysitting for you, they could cut you off. If you send them up and they're too hyper, they're too sugared up, and they're acting crazy at their house, they might cut you off with the babysitting services. You got to be careful. You can't take it too high.
Here is something grandmothers do.
What do these grandmothers do, bro?
Grandmothers do this.
What do they do?
And I if you're a grandmother.
Big mama, meemaws.
You need to learn.
Yeah.
Meema, grandma, yeah. Whatever.
Mm-hmm.
They raised you a certain way.
They sure did.
But what's good for me isn't good for my kids. The way they treated me, if I treat my kids like that.
Oh, they don't like that.
Oh, they don't like it.
They don't like that
at
all. No.
And they blame it on different times.
They sure do.
It was different times.
I didn't know
any
better.
It was different times. I didn't know any better.
Yeah.
Well, hold on. You know how you can know better?
Yeah.
I'm going to send them to you for a month.
You watch my kids.
Jacob's autistic.
Mm-hmm.
He's on the spectrum.
Mm-hmm.
The advice everybody gives me is ridiculous.
And let me guess, they don't have autistic children.
No,
of course not.
What I want to do is send Jacob over there for a day.
Oh, that'd be great.
And then you know what? I promise you this. Grandma go, you know, son, I forgot how much I love you.
Because
There's no way.
Mm-hmm.
So no, grandmas don't give advice to us.
No.
Unless you're the grandma who actually has to raise the kid, mind your business.
Agree. Mind your business. All right, our last one. Is this too petty? I just found out that my boyfriend of 3 years is sleeping with his coworker. He is colorblind. Would it be petty of me to wash all his white clothes with a red shirt of mine before breaking up with him?
Just so we're clear.
Mm-hmm.
If you want to stay with him, you can do something vengeful.
If you want to stay with him?
Yeah. If you pay back.
Yeah.
If you plan to stay in that relationship instead of just walk out.
Mm-hmm.
If you just walk out, okay, party's over.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, she wants to walk out and do something on the way out the door.
Yeah, that's how vengeance normally works. Yeah.
No, vengeance.
No.
You're
twofold.
Oh, when you're in a relationship, the vengeance happens. You stay in the relationship.
Nah.
When was the last time you did something wrong and they let you leave?
I've been married for 31 years.
No, so you never leave. You don't get to leave. I'm gonna torture you for the rest of your life.
That's how it works.
Yes.
So okay.
That's what a relationship is. You pay for your stuff.
I think you're doing relationships wrong.
Well, that's
I'm just saying. You do both.
Oh,
you do both.
I tore up his comic books.
No. She's being nice to him. Just dying his clothes. Yeah, that's you get off easy.
First off, this it ain't gonna make you feel better.
Yes, it will.
No, it's not because it's not enough.
It's something.
It's not a one and done. Dying somebody's clothes for cheating on you. Oh, I got my vengeance. No, it's not.
But you're breaking up with him.
No,
so you're done.
You're gonna make him miserable.
Mm-hmm.
And you think the clothes. Oh, you screwed up my clothes? Hey, I'll just go back. I'll buy new ones.
Gotcha.
It's not like I can't buy new clothes. I would love if that was the answer for my bad stuff. Oh, I destroyed a comic book of yours. We're even.